today?
Breast lumps.
Yeah. Because, Prof, we have already took you this topic, no? Yes or no? Prof. Miyad.
Yes, sir.
He took this topic already. He sent you his notes also. So you must be, he sent his notes on thyroid and breasts and all. I know that. So you must be knowing about the breast lump, how to examine and all. So I am going to just, I'm not going to teach you anything new. I'll be just reinforcing your knowledge because I've already shared my videos, everything with you. So you are supposed to answer today. Straight away, I am going to the case scenario because I don't want to teach you anything. Already taken by Prof. Mia. So straight away, I am going to the case scenario. Today, we are having 9 case scenarios, I think. Because I have to include both the benign breast diseases as well as the carcinoma of the breast. Okay, straight away, I am going to the case scenario. And I'll be asking, right, you all know the batch 41, especially, you know, how I conduct the PBL class. It is almost same like that. PBL, like PBL only, I'm going to concentrate only case scenario. After finishing these case scenarios, okay, I'm going to discuss one MEQ also, which I prepared some 5 years ago. So I'm going to show that MEQ also to you. You are supposed to answer all the questions. So straight away going to case number one. Okay, let me just first let me read the this case scenario. This is a 56-year-old lady. She had a left breast lump that has increased in size over the past 6 months. Okay, so what other things you want to know in history? Can you tell me? Breast lump. Okay, they are telling breast lump. Okay, it is increasing in size over the... So the duration is only 6 months. So what other question you want to ask? Can you tell me? Hello?
Is it painful?
Hello?
Is it us?
Yes?
Pain.
Yeah, is it pain or painless? Okay, painful
discharge.
Or painless? Discharge. Any nipple discharge? Okay, right. Anything else?
Is the mass mobile?
Yeah, is the mass mobile or fixed? Okay, good. Anything else? Even before asking
the breast,
even before asking the mobility, you have to ask, what is the first thing you will ask? Where is it in the breast? Which quadrant? Is it in the upper part of the breast or lower part? That you have to ask. And of course, okay, how she noticed it at first? Whether it was noticed by her during taking bath, or maybe she having, if because of the pain, she went to the clinic and only the doctor picked up the lump, all those things you have to ask. Okay, anything else you want to ask in the history? History means how, it includes, the most
how
important.
How long is the lump in present?
How long
is the lump in present?
Yeah, duration, that it's given in the history, 6 months. It's given. Yeah, anything? What?
An infection of the nipple.
Yeah, nipple discharge, somebody told already.
A retraction, sir.
Retraction, okay, good. Nipple retraction, very good. Anything else you will ask?
Any puckering, the orange changes?
Puckering, maybe they may not be knowing all these things. These are signs. Clearly, you have to know what is symptom and what is sign. Symptom is what the patient is complaining. I am asking you only the symptoms, not signs. Retraction of the nipple, okay, that comes in symptom also. Sometimes patient themselves, they can say there is retraction of the nipple, but usually it comes under signs. So what other history you will ask? History means it includes family history also. Now, can you tell me the most important thing?
Breast cancer.
Family history. So, what family history will ask?
Breast
who will get
cancer.
Affected? The patients?
Females.
Yeah, mother. Female patients. Okay, patients, mother. Okay. sibling, sisters. Yeah, okay, grandmother or the patient's children, daughter. These are the things, three generation you have to ask. Okay, what other history you will ask? Menstrual history also comes under history, no? What other thing you will ask? Hello?
Menstrual
cycle you can ask, but the most important thing is when she attained menarche. Whether she is still menstruating or already attained menopause. So these are very important things. And if she is having children, when she got pregnant, the first child pregnancy. Okay? Elderly primary is one of the risk factors. And whether she is having children, how many children she is having, and whether she breastfed all the children, or if it is no children, nulliparous woman, that is also a risk factor. And whether she is a smoker or not, whether she is using any OCP or not, any hormone therapy. So many things you have to ask in breast carcinoma. Yeah, you have to tell. And hyperlipidemia, those who are consuming a lot of fat, okay, they also will get this thing. Okay, now I will go to this question in the case scenario. What do you mean by triple assessment? Can you tell me?
Triple assessment is basically clinical examination, imaging, biopsy.
Yeah, okay. Clinical, you all know, that is history and physical. What do you mean by imaging? What imaging you will do?
Mammography, ultrasonography.
Very good. And what is the third component?
Biopsy.
Biopsy. What biopsy you will do?
FNAC or
true cut. Okay. So now if you are doing all these three things, what would be the accuracy of your diagnosis?
99.9.
99.9%. Very good. So you have to do whether it is benign or malignant, and whatever may be the age group, whether you are thinking it is benign or malignant, doesn't matter. Whenever you are encountering a lump in the breast, you have to subject to a patient for this triple assessment. This is very important. Okay. What are the other signs you can get? Can you tell me? No, okay. Breast lump. No, I will talk after this. No, now you tell me what investigations you are seeing it in these pictures. I'll ask about the clinical features later. Because now, what is this mammogram and ultrasound? Can you tell me the findings in this mammogram, and what are the two views you have to take? Mammogram.
Dense opacity.
No. Okay, you are telling the finding. Before that, what are the two views you have to take in mammogram?
Craniocaudal and medial oblique view.
Very good. Craniocaudal, medial.
The left lateral.
Yeah, okay. Now you tell me. Medial lateral. Okay, now you tell me the three features. Okay. Three or four features characteristic of
ultrasound.
Ultrasound after that. Now you tell me about the mammogram. What are the features suggestive of malignancy?
Dense opacity.
Dense opacity, okay. What about irregular, the margins?
Irregular.
Margins, irregular margin, okay. Anything else?
Asymmetry,
very good.
Clustered pleomorphic. Microcalcification.
Pleomorphic microcalcification. Good. One more thing.
Stellate or speculated
appearance. Okay. These are the characteristic feature. Okay. What is BI-RADS grading? Can you tell me? Because I am talking about the mammogram, I want to talk about that also.
Imaging reporting system.
Okay, right. Right. How many grades are there?
Six.
Six or seven? Zero to six, no? That means seven grades. Zero means what?
57. Incomplete.
Incomplete, that means you have to repeat the biopsy, that is zero. And from 1 to 6, gradually the chances of malignancy is gradually increasing. That is the grading. Okay? From 1 to 6. 6 means what? Grade 6.
Non-malignancy.
Yeah, already biopsy was done, proved to be a malignancy. That is grade 6. Okay, by rats, you must know. Okay, now we are going to go to the second, this investigation. What is this investigation?
Ultrasound.
Yeah, to whom you will do ultrasound? To which patient you will do 35. Mammogram? Yeah, what is the cutoff? That is 35 years. 35. So, which patient you will do mammogram? More above 35? Above 35, mammogram. Below 35, why you are preferring ultrasound? Why not mammogram for those who are younger than 35 years? Hello? What is the reason why you are using one
tissue?
Yeah, dense tissue in the breast that will mimic like this dense opacity. That is why you shouldn't do mammogram for those who are younger than 35 years. Okay, now coming to this ultrasound, what is the characteristic feature in breast carcinoma? You are seeing a lump there. Are you able to see some asterisk mark there? Yeah, that is the lump. Okay, hypoechoic mass is there. What is the characteristic feature of a malignant lump? It could be a fibroadenoma also. How can you tell it is malignancy?
Irregular margins.
Okay, here it doesn't look like irregular. Okay, irregular margin. Okay. Any other special features?
Hypoechoic.
Hypoechoic, okay. No, there is one specific thing. I have told in my video also. It is taller than wider. It is more tall than the width. That is the characteristic feature. If you measure the height of the tumor, that is usually more than the width of the tumor. That is the characteristic feature of malignancy in ultrasound. Okay? Right. Describe the features in the left breast. Okay. What procedure can you carry out in the clinic to further evaluate the breast lump? What you will carry out? So, breast lump means in the clinic, okay, they used to conduct what is called breast clinic, special breast clinic on a particular day in the month, maybe second Friday or something like that. Okay, in that day, all the breast cases, they used to come there. And how will you confirm your diagnosis? Now, can you tell me what investigation you must do to confirm your diagnosis?
Biopsy.
Yeah, biopsy. What are the two types of biopsies, you know? True cut and FNAC. Among the two, which is better for breast lump?
True cut.
Why?
Lower false negative.
Tissue.
Yeah, low false negative. Okay, agreed. Anything else?
Tissue.
Yeah.
Candy tissue.
Yeah, because we are seeing the tissue in core needle biopsy. Whereas in FNAC, what we are examining?
Cells.
Yeah, that is cellular level. That's need an expert cytopathologist. Yeah, not all pathologists can read FNAC. That is another disadvantage. Any other thing? Any other point? You cannot differentiate in-situ carcinoma from invasive carcinoma in case of FNAC. Whereas if you do a true cut, yes, you can do. Another thing is you cannot make out the ER and PR positive status in FNAC, whereas in true cut, you can do this. These are the different points in favor of true cut over FNAC for a breast lump. Yeah. What is the management mode of this patient means? What you have to do? What is your aim? What you are trying to do? So you have to do the staging. That is very important. Before any carcinoma, whatever may be, not only for breast carcinoma, any carcinoma anywhere in the body, you must, before deciding the treatment, you are supposed to do what is called staging. So I will talk about it. What are the staging investigation you have to do in the next maybe in the next scenarios. Okay, now I am going to the case number 2. 45-year-old woman presented with a mass in the left breast. Describe the finding. This is the mass. They are not saying anything else. Only pictures speaks now. So you are seeing a mass there. Just by looking into that, what is coming to your mind immediately? What could be the reason? They didn't give even the duration of this mass. Patient has come with this mass. Okay, what you will ask the patient and what is coming to your mind, what you had to rule out? Can you tell me?
Maybe it's breast abscess.
Breast abscess, very good. Immediately you have to think of breast abscess because you are seeing nipple retraction there. Okay, that could be a cause for the breast abscess. What else you have to ask? Breast abscess coming to your mind. What question you want to ask the patient? Painful or painless? Good.
Is it a history of lactation or
lactation? History of what? History of
lactation.
Fluctuation. Fluctuation is a sign. It is a sign.
Lactation. Breastfeeding.
Breastfeeding. Okay, right. That you can get. Okay, anything. Breastfeeding. Okay, that can cause. I mean, lactating. You want to know whether it is lactating breast or not, because only in lactating mothers. This breast abscess is very common. Okay. Is there anything, something, you are seeing some other investigation here. Now, the second investigation. Having seen the second investigation, now what do you think about the pathology here in the first picture? You are seeing something in the second picture. Some rainbow color in the sternum. What is it? Are you able to see some rainbow color? You are seeing all the color.
Yes.
Yeah, what is that scan? What is that scan? Only in one scan you will see this rainbow color.
PET scan.
Very good. Excellent. PET scan. PET scan will be positive in which pathology? Breast abscess, will it be positive? Will it be positive in breast abscess? PET scan you will do for which pathology? Hello?
Breast
abscess.
Cancer.
Breast carcinoma. Yeah, it is breast carcinoma. So that means probably this is a case of breast carcinoma. But which breast carcinoma will be having this inflammatory reaction? There is a special variant of breast carcinoma known as inflammatory breast carcinoma. So this could be a case of inflammatory breast carcinoma because they are showing an investigation of PET scan positive. This patient is having secondaries in the rib, especially not in the rib, in the sternum. Are you able to see this? So this is PET scan. So what is this PET scan? Can you expand this PET scan, PET? Yes. Positron emission tomography, that is PET scan. Okay, fluorodeoxyglucose, FDG. That is the material you have to give to the patient before taking this PET scan. What is this? This is a glucose only. Why we are giving this FDG to the patient? Because wherever there is cancer cell in the body, they need more energy. So they take more glucose, yeah? And that is why after giving this FDG, this is fluorodeoxyglucose. So it is fluorescent glucose. So it is going there that secondaries or the cancer cell will take more glucose there. That is why you are seeing that rainbow color in the sternum. Not only in the secondaries, even in the primary, in the breast itself, you can see this. Wherever there is malignant cells, you can see this one. Because a lot of glucose will be taken up by these cells. Okay. Now, what are the important aspects of the patient's history you told already? Which is the best way to make a diagnosis? This also we have discussed. So what you have to do now, you have to do a Truckert biopsy. Okay. What investigations are done to stage the disease? Okay. Can you tell me, apart from this PET scan, what other investigation you want to do to staging, to stage a breast carcinoma? Can you tell me? Breast carcinoma, what are the investigation you will do for staging purpose?
Sentinel
lymph node biopsy. Okay, I will talk about it later because one of our case scenarios is based on that sentinel. I'm not going to talk about it now, just now. I'll be talking on that particular case scenario. Anything else you want to do? Any other? Yeah, what?
Radionuclide
bone scan. So what radioisotope you will use?
Technetium.
Technetium-99. So what is the other name for this scan? Radioisotope scan. Is there any other name for this? It is also known as scintigraphy. And you had to do whole body bone scan. Whole body bone scan. So you had to give technetium-99. So maybe I will be showing that also in another case scenario, because you have to use this one. It will be taken up by wherever there are secondaries in the bone that will take up this radioisotope technetium-99, and you can see that. But you have to take that film not using your ordinary X-ray machine, because it is a radioisotope. You have to use the gamma camera to take the picture. This you have to remember. Okay, this is one thing for bone secondaries. Any other investigation you will do to staging the disease? Bone scan is for whole body bone scan is one thing. Any other investigation? suppose if it is liver mets, what investigation you will do to pick it up? Only ultrasound. Ultrasound you can do. Apart from CT abdomen also you can do. Yeah, very good. Okay, you can do either ultrasound or CT. Any other, in a female patient, will it get, deposited in any other organ in the abdomen?
Pouch of Douglas. Ovary.
Before ovary. Pouch of Douglas, yeah, ovary. Suppose if it is getting deposited in the ovary, what is the tumor called? What is the name of the tumor? Krukenberg's tumor. Very good. Very good. Is it common in pre-menopausal women or post-menopausal women?
Pre-menopausal. Yeah.
Very good. Excellent. Pre-menopausal. Why not in post-menopausal? Why it is common in pre-menopausal? Yeah?
Atrophy in post-menopausal.
Post-menopausal, it is already atrophied ovary. Because in pre-menopausal area, every month, the graafian follicle will rupture and there is a raw area in the ovary. So that is a very good nidus for the cancer cell to get deposited and grow. Okay? This is your soil and seed theory. Only if the soil is fertile, then only the seed will germinate. You all know this. So this is the soil and seed theory. So only if the ovary is active, then only your cancer cells will go and get implanted and then grow. So this is what is called Krukenberg's tumor. It is common in premenopausal women. Postmenopausal, already it is atrophied ovary. It won't grow there. Okay. Suppose if it is a female patient, you said it is also getting deposited in the pouch of Douglas. Agree. Suppose if it is a male patient, male patient also can get carcinoma of the breast. Where it will get deposited? In a male patient. In the pelvis. Rectovesical pouch. Yeah, very good. So suppose if it is getting deposited in the rectovesical pouch, you can feel it by doing a digital rectal examination. What is that is called? Some self. I am giving you a clue. That is called, if you do a digital rectal, you can feel that tumor in the rectovesical pouch. That is called by some name. What self it is? Self, S-H-E-L-F. Blumer's self. Okay? It is. I think you know that. You all studied in your pathology already. So, okay. This is for abdominal secondaries. Suppose if it is pulmonary secondary, how will you make out? What investigation?
Chest X-ray.
Okay, chest X-ray. What are the two findings you can see in pulmonary mets?
Cannonball appearance.
Okay, very good. Cannonball appearance is one presentation. How else it can present? Pulmonary mets.
Malignant pleural effusion.
Malignant, very good, excellent. Malignant pleural effusion. Yeah, these are the two ways by which it can. What procedure has been performed in picture B? What can be seen? This we have discussed already. So I am going to the next case scenario. Okay, this film we have discussed already. This is PET scan. So, okay, before doing the PET scan, what material you have to give to the patient? I told you. Can you tell me? You have to FDG. Give something. Yeah, FDG. Fluorodeoxyglucose. Why you are giving glucose? Can you tell me?
It's taken up by the cancer cells.
Yeah, many of these glucose will be, the cancer cell will pick up more glucose than the ordinary cells. That is the basis of this PET scan. Okay, right. Going to the next case scenario. This is a 25-year-old girl presented with a mobile breast lump that was excised. So this is very easy. You can see a lump here. What are the differential diagnoses of breast lump for patients in this age group? Can you tell me? 25 years. Young girl. Number one, fibroadenoma. What else? Suppose if the patient is also having the pain during menstruation. Cyclical mastalgia. Then what is your diagnosis? Lump in the breast with more pain during the premenstrual period. What is that lump? This is common in middle-aged women. This is also known as ANDI. Abnormal development and involution. What is it? This is fibroadenosis or fibrocystic disease. Okay, that will result like this. Okay, differential diagnosis. What is the probable diagnosis in this case? All of you told it is fibroadenoma. How does it present? Suppose if you examine, patient will be having a breast lump. Okay, it could be a single lump or maybe it may be, sometimes it may be multiple. One breast or it can occur in both breasts also simultaneously. Okay. But what is the characteristic classical feature? If you try to palpate it, what will happen?
Mobile.
Freely mobile breast mouse.
Yeah, that is why it is called breast mouse. What can be seen from the histology? So you are seeing here something. So this is, you see the difference between this ultrasound scan and the scan which I have shown in a case of breast carcinoma. See the here, the width is more than the height. Are you able to see? It is horizontally oval in shape. Whereas the breast carcinoma which I showed you, the ultrasound picture, the height is more than the width. Here also you are seeing a hypoechoic mass, but the width is more than the height. Whereas in carcinoma, the height will be more than the width. This is the main difference. Okay. Suppose, okay, this is the histological picture. There are histology you need not know because only pathologists will be interested about it. There are two types of fibroadenomas, pericanalicular and intracanalicular. All those things are of interest to pathologists. They will give you the diagnosis. Okay. Suppose, how will you manage this condition? Fibroadenoma. What will you do? Yes. All fibroadenomas, will you do surgery? Hello?
Yes. Surgical excision.
Not to all fibroadenomas. Suppose if your lump is less than 2 cm, what will you do? Less than 2 cm, what will you do? You have to just observe the patient. Yeah. You can say the patient, okay, nothing. But you must do the triple assessment. You must do a biopsy. You have to rule out a malignancy. I told you whatever may be the age group and whether you are thinking it is benign or malignant, you should do the triple assessment. So you must do a FNAC or TRUCAT. Then only you have to tell the patient, okay, if it is less than 2 cm, okay, you need not bother about it. It is unlikely to be malignancy. But if you develop any problem, you have to come back to me. This is what you have to tell. Suppose if the lump is more than, say, around 3 cm, 4 or up to 5, even 5 cm, then what will you do? More than 2 cm, then you have to do excision biopsy. That is what you are seeing here in this picture. This is lobulated mass. And it is having capsule also. Well encapsulated tumor. So that is why we used to do what is called enucleation. You have to incise the cyst and you have to remove only the inside tumor. The cyst wall of this fibroadenoma will be there in the breast only. You need not remove it actually, because this is not a malignancy. You have to incise the cyst and then you have to remove it. Usually, after removing it, there is a bleeder from the cyst which you have to control. That's all, then you can close it. This is a very simple surgery. Suppose if you are not, patient is having a big, say, 3 or 4 cm fibroadenoma. You haven't removed it. Patient also ignored it. What complication can happen? Patient is having it for 15 years. 10 years, 15 years. What can happen to that fibroadenoma? Did you watch my video? I told in that some calcification. What is that calcification? Can you tell me? Hello? That means you didn't watch my video properly. What calcification? Popcorn calcification. Popcorn calcification. That resembles like a popcorn. Okay, now we are going to the next case scenario. Okay. 40-year-old lady presented with heaviness and associated skin changes in her right breast. This you can see it. See, right breast is, bigger than the left breast. And if you compare the nipple areola, the right breast is at a higher level. So that means patient is having some pathology in the right breast. You have to look, the first thing you have to look is symmetry, whether it is asymmetry or symmetry. That is the first. Describe the abnormal physical signs seen in the pictures. I told you already. So I could have asked you. Instead, I told you the findings. Okay. List the 2 conditions that can give rise to the above appearance. Can you tell me?
Breast carcinoma.
Yeah, okay. Where else you will get this? You are having some nipple retraction also. Are you able to make out? Breast abscess also, yeah, good. Breast abscess also, that breast will be bigger. Yeah, it can happen in chronic breast abscess. Okay. What is the pathogenesis of this one?
Obstruction of lymphatic.
Yeah, here you are seeing something. What you are seeing here in this picture, can you tell me?
Pudi
orange. Yeah, it is pudi orange appearance. What are the two pathologies in which you can develop pudi orange? Pudi orange could be because of carcinoma of the breast, or it could be breast abscess. Okay, what is the cause for pudi orange in CA breast? What is the cause? Subdermal lymphatic obstruction. Very good, excellent. Okay, subdermal lymphatic. But how come you are getting this pitted appearance? You are seeing some pits, no, in the skin. What is that actually?
The hair follicles cannot.
Very good. Because of the subdermal lymphatic obstruction, there will be lymphedema. The skin of the breast can swell, but not the hair follicles. Hair follicle cannot swell because of the lymphedema. And that is why you are seeing this multiple pitted appearance that resembles like the orange peel. That is why it is called pudi orange. Yeah, okay. In breast abscess also, it can happen. So how will you confirm now? You have to do an ultrasound, find out whether patient is having inside a lump, or you have to palpate and see whether patient is having a lump or a generalized, swelling. Or you can put a needle and find out. If it is a breast abscess, okay, if you put a needle, what will come out? What will come out if you put a needle? pus will come out. Pus will come out. If it is a tumor, probably it is CA breast. Okay? That is how, now I am going to the next case. Because we are having 9 case scenarios. Going to the 5th one. Okay. This is one of the investigations. Okay, this also I want to show you. 45-year-old lady had needle localization biopsy, okay, and excision of a breast lesion. What you are seeing in picture A? What is this investigation? Can you tell me? You are seeing some 2 wires going into the breast and it has been hooked there. So in which, what is the name of this investigation? Can you tell me? Yeah, in which patients you will do needle localization biopsy? Those patients who are not having, clinically there is no lump, but while they are undergoing screening mammogram, in Western countries, all women above 45 or 50 years must undergo this mammogram. Because this is what is called the screening. They will do it in the society. All females above 45 years must undergo this mammogram. What is the idea? What is the purpose? They want to pick up the breast cancer in the early stage. Okay? While doing that screening, okay, the radiologist has picked up some suspicious area in the breast. Then only you have to do this needle localization biopsy. And there is another biopsy also I have mentioned in my video. What is the other one you can do? Apart from needle localization, where you have to remove, the surgeon has to remove the one. Again, he has to send it back to the radiologist. Radiologist, again, he has to do the mammogram. And then he will send to the pathologist.
Stereotactic.
Very good. Excellent. Stereotactic biopsy. So, who will take the biopsy in stereotactic biopsy?
Computer
assisted. Yeah, it is computer assisted one. Yeah, I think you might have seen it in my video. The lady will be lying in a prone position with a big hole in the turbo. The hole, that side of the upper limb and that side of the breast will be hanging down. And the machine itself, because this is a computer assisted machine, the machine itself will localize the lesion and it will take the biopsy. That is called stereotactic biopsy. Very good. Excellent. And this is the pathology. Okay. And here you are seeing only the cancer cell is only inside the duct. So what is that? It is not coming outside the basement membrane. So what is that? In situ carcinoma, DCIS, yeah, ductal carcinoma in situ. What is the other in situ carcinoma? One is duct, developing from the duct. What is the other one?
Lobular
carcinoma or LCIS. Lobular carcinoma in situ and ductal carcinoma in situ. Suppose if it is ductal carcinoma in situ, yeah, it is not invasive carcinoma. Still, it is very early stage. So, if you are picking up the cancer at this stage, how will you manage them? If you are not going to do anything, definitely they are going to develop invasive ductal carcinoma. So, what you can do now? You can do the local lumpectomy. Yeah, remove that area only. Yeah, remove that suspicious area only, you can remove it. And of course, you have to observe the patient. But if you don't want to take any risk, okay, then you do mastectomy. Yeah, that is how you have to manage this one. Okay, coming to the next case. Now, here I am showing some investigation. Okay, I will show you. Before that, 40-year-old lady experienced pain in her left breast. What you are seeing her in the left breast? Can you tell me?
Ulceration
of the nipple areola complex. But if you are seeing it only on one side, what could be your diagnosis? You are seeing some sore or ulcer, Paget's disease of the nipple. What is the differential diagnosis? Suppose if it is on both sides. If it is on both sides, it is eczema. Yeah. I think I have given some 10 differential points in my videos. Go and read them, how to differentiate this thing. But what is the most likely diagnosis? It could be either a Paget's disease or could be an advanced breast carcinoma. What can be seen from the bone scan? This is the bone scan. What is this scan? What is this scan? Bone scan. Whole body bone scan. But what is the other, what material we are using it for this scan?
Technetium.
Technetium 99. What is the other name for this isotope bone scan? Scintigraphy. So what gadget you will, okay, very good, excellent. What gadget you will use to take this picture? No, no. What gadget you will use? Will you use X-ray? I told you. What will you use to take this picture? Will you, is it an X-ray or what? Gamma camera, yeah. You have to use gamma camera to take. You can see wherever there are secondaries in the bone, okay, you are seeing the concentration is more in the bladder. Of course, one is bladder and in the pelvis also. The whole of the vertebra also, you are seeing a lot of secondaries. Are you able to see? This is what is called whole body bone scan. Yeah, this is what I want to show you. Suppose if somebody is having secondaries in the bone, what is the staging of the this breast disease? Yeah, breast carcinoma, what is the stage if there is secondaries in the bone?
Four.
Yes, what is the stage? Stage four, yeah, okay. Stage four. Suppose I have shown you in the previous case scenario, a pediorin. Your patient is having pediorin. What is the stage of that breast cancer? Yes?
Stage three.
Stage three, very good. All skin changes comes under stage three. Stage one means the tumor is less than 2 cm. Stage two is 2 to 5 cm. Stage three, skin involvement. Stage four, distant metastasis. I think I have given the treatment also for early breast cancer, localized advanced breast cancer, and advanced breast cancer. I think if you have watched my videos, okay, then you will be knowing. I'll be asking all those things in the next case scenario. So this is for, I think this is for breast nipple discharge. 35-year-old woman presented with right nipple discharge for a duration of 1 month. Okay. What other information about the discharge is important? Can you tell me? What color. Other thing?
Color.
Yeah, what is the color? You will ask the color, whether it is bloody, whether it is yellowish color, whether it is white color. Okay. Suppose if it is blood, what are the causes? Blood discharge. What are the causes?
Duct ectasia,
no, green color. What is the commonest? No. What is the commonest cause for bloody nipple discharge? Intraductal? Intraductal papilloma. What is the number two cause?
Papilloma.
Intraductal carcinoma. These are the two causes. Yeah, among these, the ductal papilloma is the most common cause. Okay, right. Suppose if the discharge
papilloma.
Is pus. Yeah, correct.
Papilloma.
Suppose if the color is yellowish color, what could be the cause?
Abscess.
Yellow color, yeah, it is abscess or it could be duct ectasia. Suppose if it is greenish color, greenish tinge, what it could be?
Duct ectasia
and one more thing, where you will have cyclical mastalgia also. What is that condition?
Fibroadenosis,
yeah, correct. So when will you suspect malignancy if there is, bloody nipple discharge? Yeah. What are the characteristic feature of malignancy producing nipple discharge? Yes?
It is spontaneous.
Very good. Excellent. And it is spontaneous. It is unilateral. Involving only one duct and it is not sticky. If it is a benign condition, usually the discharge will be sticky in nature. If it is malignancy, usually it is non-sticky. This also you have to know. Okay, what are the common causes? Okay, all these things we have discussed. Which kinds of non-invasive investigation would you perform to help manage the condition? So what non-invasive investigation you can do?
What?
Ultrasound, yeah, ultrasound is the best thing. Okay, if the investigation are not conclusive and the nipple discharge persists, what else you can do? Okay, ultrasound you did, but it is not conclusive. It is, can you do anything else for the nipple discharge?
Needle aspiration.
If you are palpating a lump also, then you can do a FNAC. Okay, but there is no lump. Okay, then what will you do? Is there any other investigation can you do something there in the duct itself? Put something inside and you can visualize?
Needle localizing.
You can inject a dye and you can take a picture. Ductography you can do, or nowadays they are having a ductoscopy also. Yeah, very small miniature scopy that you can put individual ducts and you can visualize inside. But I haven't seen, so far I haven't seen, because how can they make a very, very small this thing? I don't know. I haven't seen in my experience. But I have read only in the book, ductoscopy. That also they are doing nowadays. But I haven't seen so far in my experience. Maybe these are all the recent advances. Ductoscopy you can do, or you can inject a dye and you can take a ductography also you can do. Yeah, find out whether there is inside the duct, is there any tumor. Maybe it could be a papilloma also. It could be an intraductal carcinoma also. Yeah, all those things you can make out by doing this thing. Suppose if it is an intraductal papilloma, what is the treatment? Papilloma, cancer means you have to do mastectomy. If it is a papilloma, yes. But you have to do microdocectomy. Very good. How will you do microdocectomy? You have to put either a needle or a proline stitch in that particular duct, and you have to make a radial incision. You have to excise that particular duct throughout, and you have to remove that tumor also. This is what is called microdocectomy. You are removing only that particular lactiferous duct. Okay, very good. We are going to, now this is the sentinel lymph node biopsy. The lady had surgery in her left axilla. What you are seeing there? What kind of surgery was performed? I told you the answer. This is sentinel lymph node biopsy. When will you do the sentinel lymph node biopsy? Will you do for all cases, or what are the indications for? Yeah,
early
breast cancer. Very good. In stage 1 and stage 2 only you have to do it. Okay. If patient is already having a proved metastasis, you need not do it. How will you do this? What are the two methods? One is dye method, another one is dye method. What dye you will give?
Lymphazurin blue dye.
How will you give this dye? What you will
inject
do?
Inject on the tumor.
Very good. Inject right over the tumor. When will you inject? Yeah, you are operating the patient. When will you inject? Just before operating, you have to inject. You have to take the patient to the OT. Just before, what dye you will inject? Lymphozurin blue. Okay. You have injected the dye. Wait. What is the duration? You have to wait for some time. What is the duration? Wait 10 to 15 minutes. Then you have opened the axilla. What you are seeing there in the picture?
The color is seen. Dye is
the
seen.
The first lymph node that is draining that lump will turn into blue color. So what you have to do with this lymph node?
Frozen section.
Yeah, you have to remove it and send it for frozen section. What do you mean by frozen section biopsy? Yes? What do you mean by frozen section biopsy? The pathologist will be telling you whether it is malignant or not within 10 to 15 minutes. So what we used to do after doing this biopsy, sentinel lymph node biopsy, I'll be sitting on a chair, stool, in the theater. So after 10 to 15 minutes, the pathologist will be calling you by intercom. The circulating nurse will bring the intercom to you, and you have to talk with the pathologist. The pathologist will directly talk with you and tell to you whether the lymph node is malignant or not. If they are telling the lymph node is malignant, okay, you go ahead and complete your modified radical mastectomy. If they are telling this lymph node is not malignant, okay, you need not do anything, you close the axilla. Yeah. I'm not telling that you need not do anything. As far as axilla is concerned, you need not do axillary clearance. Close the axilla and you have to do only the mastectomy. Okay, mastectomy still you have to do. If you are having a lump, you must do mastectomy, but you need not do the axillary clearance. Why? What is the problem with axillary clearance? If you do axillary clearance, what complications can happen to that particular limb, upper limb?
Post-surgical
edema. Lymphedema can happen. Okay, this is one method, this dye method. What is the other method of doing this sentinel lymph node biopsy? Yes? Technetium. Is it technetium 99 or something else?
Technetium 99.
Here you are seeing. This is the technetium 99 with what?
Sulfur colloid.
You have to mix it with sulfur colloid. And they took this picture. But usually in the theater, you need not do this. This is the scan they have done with gamma camera. But you need not do this because the lump in the breast and the axillary node both have picked up the dye. You can see that. But actually, you need not do this scan. You have opened the this thing, axilla. But this isotope, you have to give one day prior. Unlike the prior one, that lymphozurin method, here you have to give the radioisotope, that is technetium 99 with sulfur colloid, you have to give one day prior to surgery. You have to give IV. And then the next day, you have to do, you just open the axilla, but now there is no color change. No? How will you pick up which lymph node is involved? How will you know that lymph node? What you have to do?
Portable gamma camera.
Very good. Gamma camera is usually a big instrument, but we are having a portable gamma camera like your pen. That thing you have to sew just over this axilla. You open the axilla like that, but there won't be any color change there. You just sew that portable gamma camera over that, you will get a signal, audio signal like beep, 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 it will come. If you are going to sew it just above the node only, it will come. If you are sewing it in other areas, you won't get any audio signal. This is how you have to pick up which is the lymph node that is involved. Then you have to remove it. The other things are same. You have to remove it and send it for frozen section biopsy. Very good. Okay. In what other pathologies? Yeah. Okay. This sentinel lymph node biopsy is done in some other pathology, not only in breast carcinoma. In some other pathology also, we used to do this sentinel lymph node biopsy. What are those pathologies, I am asking you? Yes? Something in the skin carcinoma. Okay, I'm giving you the clue. That is malignant melanoma. Very good. Yeah, and in external genitalia in male patient, carcinoma of the penis, penile carcinoma and the malignant melanoma. In both the pathologies, there also we are doing this sentinel lymph node biopsy. Very good. We are going to the last case. This is 52-year-old Chinese lady who had this surgery for phylloides tumor. It is phylloides tumor. So tell me what surgery was performed. Phylloides tumor.
Radical mastectomy. No, wrong.
It is not modified radical mastectomy. Will you do modified radical mastectomy for a phylloides tumor? It is not a malignant variety. Phyllodes tumor could be malignant also. It is not a malignant variety. It is a benign one. Phyllodes tumor, it is a potentially malignant tumor. Pre-malignant condition. It is not a malignant one. So what surgery was performed? Can you tell me?
Wide excision.
It is just total mastectomy. Yeah, that is what they did. Just total mastectomy they did in this patient. Okay, phyllodes tumor, how it spreads? Can you tell me? Lymphatic, vascular or local invasion? Can you tell me? Local invasion, okay. Okay, what about lymphatics and vascular? Is it spreading through lymphatics and vascular? No. It is not spreading. Okay, because it is not a malignant tumor. So that is why only if it becomes the malignant variety, I told you, no, then only it can spread. Usually, majority of the phyllodes tumor, it won't spread. That is why the treatment is just total mastectomy. Simple total mastectomy. That's all you have to do. You need not do anything about the axillary lymph node because there is no lymphatic spread. Okay, why it is called phyllodes? Why? What do you mean by phyllodes?
Leaf-like.
Okay. Phyllodes tumor, is it a small tumor or a big one?
Very large.
It is usually, this occupies the whole of the breast. That side. Okay. Here, they did this total mastectomy. What are the variation of this mastectomy? Total mastectomy. There are some variations. Okay, this is too much for you. This is for postgraduates. You can spare the skin because here they haven't removed the skin. And you can spare the nipple areola also, you can spare. That is subcutaneous mastectomy, it's called. Okay, these are some of the technical variation. I think this is not for you. What are its indication? That is also okay. What are the options for reconstruction? Because this is a benign condition, almost benign, phyllodes. So if it is a young woman, okay, they may want to reconstruct. How will you reconstruct the breast after mastectomy? You can do it, if it is a benign condition like phyllodes, you can do it while you are doing the mastectomy itself, you can reconstruct. Reconstruct the breast. How will you reconstruct? What you can use? Yeah?
Silicone implants.
Yeah, silicone implant you can do, but there is a lot of problem with this silicone implant nowadays. It can rupture. It can produce malignancy. That itself can produce malignancy also. In long term, silicone implant is one thing. Any other muscle flap, you know? Okay, all these things I didn't discuss in my video, I agree. This is called TRAM, T-R-A-M. You have to take the rectus abdominis muscle of that side and then you have to make it as a breast mount. Yeah, that is TRAM, TRAM surgery. Okay, now I am closing this one. It's almost 1 hour now. I am closing this, but I told you, no, I'll be discussing a MEQ also. I am going to the MEQ. That is what you will be asked in your, 1 minute. This is what wait a minute, breast, where is it? MEQ, where is it? Burns. What? Yeah, okay. Okay, this is a slide. I think I prepared some 5 years ago when I joined here. 5-6 years ago, when I was in Malacca, okay, I remember, I prepared this slide. Okay, doesn't matter nowadays, the same thing, okay. MEQ is like this only, because I want you to have a feel of how we will be asking you the MEQ question for you. So usually there'll be 5 slides. Each slides, you will have 1, 2, or 3 questions. We will give a scenario like this. 40 years old lady came to the breast clinic with complaints of self-detected 3 into 2 centimeter size, painless hard lump with restricted mobility in her right breast for the past 2 months. You are seeing the lump here. Okay, they have marked the lump also. This is 3 into 2 cm. What is your probable diagnosis? Yes? Painless lump, hard in consistency, restricted breast mobility. Carcinoma. Breast carcinoma. Breast carcinoma. Yes, carcinoma. Very good. Okay. In which quadrant you are? It is very common.
Upper lateral.
In which quadrant?
Right, upper.
Why it is very common is in upper and outer quadrant. Why? Because you are also having axillary tail of Spence. More breast tissue here in this quadrant. That is the cause. Enumerate the various risk factors for this pathology. Can you tell me? I told you so many things. Risk factors for CA breast.
Familial history.
Familial. Yeah, okay, right. Family history, right. Yeah. Early menarche, early menarche, late menopause, hyperlipidemia, okay. Yes, nulliparous women, elderly primary, those who are smoking, hyperlipidemia. See, so many causes are there. So you have to tell all these things. These are the various risk factors. And the patients who are already, they are having breast cancer in one breast, they are having more risk to develop the cancer in the other breast. Yeah? Okay. Now, the ipsilateral and contralateral axilla were normal without any palpable lymph nodes. A provisional diagnosis of CA breast was made. What are the clinical features of carcinoma of the breast? What you are seeing here in this picture?
PD orange.
So what is the cause for the PD orange? Can you repeat? Once again, I am repeating it once again because this is very important. Yeah? Subdermal lymphatic obstruction. Why you are seeing that pitted appearance is because of what?
Hair follicle.
Okay. What is this picture? What you are seeing?
Bloody nipple discharge.
What is the commonest cause for bloody nipple discharge?
Intraductal papilloma.
Okay, right. What is this biopsy you are seeing? You are seeing some needle. What is this? Effenesia. This is not effenesia. Effenesia is your ordinary syringe, number 23 syringe. This is a true cut biopsy. You are seeing an incision, no? They have made a skin incision over the breast. So this is a FNAC. Okay. Sorry, this is true cut biopsy or core needle biopsy. And okay, you all know what is the true cut biopsy, what is the advantage. I discussed all those things. I'm not going to repeat once again. To confirm the diagnosis, mammography and true cut biopsy were done already. Okay, you are seeing some picture there. What is this investigation?
Needle localization.
Very good. I am not going to ask anything more. What is this investigation? This is the same thing you might have seen in my videos. Yeah. Stereotactic biopsy. Very good. Very good. So what is this? What is this picture you are seeing? What investigation it is?
Mammography.
Tell me the three features. Characteristic feature of mammographic features. I told already.
Ill-defined margins.
Ill-defined margin. Microcalcification. Pleomorphic. Microcalcification. And stellate or speculated appearance. Okay, very good. Apart from FNAC, TrueCut, what are the other methods of biopsy? Okay, we have answered already. TrueCut biopsy report came as infiltrating ductal carcinoma with ER and PR positive. What is the tumor marker for CA breast? This I didn't tell you, but it is there. CA, yeah, correct. CA 15-3. Yeah, CA 15-3. Yeah, BRCA1 and BRCA2 and HER2 new are receptors. They are not tumor markers. They are receptors, hormone receptors. Okay. What investigation? Yeah, what is the tumor marker? What is its role? What is the role of this tumor marker? Just because your patient is having this CA 15-3 is elevated, can you tell that this is carcinoma breast? What is the significance of this? What is its role, in other words? Is it diagnostic? I am asking you.
Prognostic.
Yes? Yeah?
Prognostic.
what is its main role? The main role is you want to pick up the recurrence during the follow-up, during your surveillance. Whenever I told you, no, the patients, especially if they're having carcinoma, they have to come and meet the surgeon quite often. Whenever they are coming to you, at least once in 6 months, you should do the CA15-3. Suppose immediately after surgery, it is not increased. But suddenly in one of these visits, if it is abnormally increased, that means patient has developed some secondary somewhere in the body, and it is our duty to do the investigation and to localize where it is, where is the recurrence. That is the role of this tumor markers. Okay. Patient belongs to which stage of the tumor? It is 3 into 2, no skin changes, 3 into 2 centimeters. So what stage it is? Stage 2. How will you do sentinel lymph node biopsy? This also, I'm not, because I've talked with you about it in detail. The two methods, lymphosurine method and the technetium 99 sulfur colloid method. Both I have discussed with you already. So I'm going to the next one. Sentinel lymph node biopsy was negative. Workup, that is investigation to pick up distant metastasis, was also negative. So it was decided to do surgical intervention. What are the two options for surgical intervention? So this is early breast carcinoma. So what surgery you can do? I have mentioned two options. What you can do? Number one, you can do breast conservation, or you can go for MRM. MRM means modified radical mastectomy. So only one question. What are the components of breast conservation surgery? Can you tell me?
Lumpectomy.
Quadrantectomy. Wide local excision. Okay, only one question. Oh, after doing all this, any one of these surgeries, what else you should do in these patients? Breast conservation surgery. What else you have to do? You have to do a radiotherapy. Where you should give the radiotherapy?
Chest wall.
To the chest only, chest wall. Yeah, very good. Why you should give after breast conservation surgery? Why should you give this radiotherapy? Yeah. Somebody told.
Micrometastasis.
Yeah, there will be micrometastasis in the chest wall. So if you are not going to do anything, this small micrometastasis will blown up into a carcinoma breast. In order to avoid this, we are giving radiotherapy. There is no breast conservation surgery without radiotherapy. Yeah, post-op radiotherapy. This you have to remember. Okay, you are seeing, this is one of my patients. I removed the carcinoma breast. Okay, I still remember, this is a Muslim patient. She came to me. Yeah, I did it while I was working in Apollo Group of Hospitals in India. I still remember. Okay, this patient came under the health minister's healthcare program. Okay, I remember this patient. Okay, you have to make an elliptical incision. I am showing you, this is my hand only. I am showing you, maybe I'm not showing my face, but you can see that artery forceps, I am pointing the tumor. I am just excising the tumor from the breast. Okay, I'm doing the mastectomy here. And here in the second picture, you are seeing after mastectomy, I am lifting something there with one hand. What is that I am lifting? The skin muscle I am lifting. That is the skin. Muscle you are seeing lying low down, the second hand. Second hand below, you are seeing along with that, you are seeing one muscle. What is that muscle in the chest? Pectoralis major, you are seeing there. And you are seeing some triangular area there. What is that? Below the second hand, lower down to the second hand, you are seeing some triangular area. What is that?
Axilla.
That is axilla. And in the axilla, you are seeing something is, if you carefully look in the apex of the axilla, something is running horizontally. And that is having a blue tinge also. Maybe you cannot see it very clearly. Blue tinge also. What is that vascular structure? That is axillary vein. So you have to remove only up to that area. You have to be very careful. Yeah, you should not dissect above this axillary vein. Yeah, what are the two nerves you shouldn't injure while you are doing mastectomy?
Axillary.
If you injure that nerve, the patient will go for winging of scapula. Can you tell me now?
Long thoracic
nerve of bell and thoracodorsal nerve. These are the two nerves you should not injure. One is supplying serratus anterior, another one is supplying the latissimus dorsi. So you should not, and here in the third picture, this is the patient. You are seeing the patient is tube, endotracheal tube is there, and you are seeing I have closed the skin incision, big skin incision, elliptical skin incision. See, it is going up to the axilla. And you are seeing drain. How many drains I have used here?
Two.
Yes?
Two.
Two drains. So one for axilla, another drain for the anterior chest wall. And both you can connect it, Y connector, and you can put it into a Redivac drain. Redivac means vacuum drain. Yeah? Vacuum drain so that whatever collection is there in the chest will get sucked out. That is Redivac drain. This is what we are doing it. How long you have to keep the drain? Can you tell me? Normally, drain we have to keep for 48 hours. But here, because of extensive dissection, there will be lot of discharge. So what is the thing which will decide when to remove the drain? Suppose if the discharge is below 40 ml or 50 ml, below 40 ml, then you can remove it. Usually, we keep it for maybe for 7 days also we used to keep it because it won't, decrease usually. So you have to remove only after this thing. Yeah, here I have sutured the skin with, silk. But you can do it with skin stapler also. Okay, this is a modified radical mastectomy I did in this patient. So this patient is having ER and PR positive. What drug will you give to this patient post-operatively? Yeah, what hormone treatment you will give? Can you tell me?
Tamoxifen.
Tamoxifen. Okay, but what is the problem with tamoxifen?
It can cause
endometrial cancer and VTE, that is venous thromboembolism. Nowadays we are using another drug called raloxifene. The dose for tamoxifene is 20 milligram oral tablet. You have to give it for 5 years. That is why 5 years you have to give patients more prone to develop this endometrial carcinoma. I think that's it. This is answer key is also there. Okay, answer key is also there. Okay, thank you. Okay, now I'm coming there.